Welcome to Monster Review, where we take a look at tech tips, and how-to videos. Today we'll be looking at the MYQ Smart Garage Hub by Chamberlin. It's going to be replacing my linear go control hub that does not work with my new Chamberlin garage door opener. So we are going to do an unboxing of this hub and also a full testing to make sure that we can get the same functions that we got with the linear go control hub when it worked with my old garage door opener. There are a lot of rumors online that say that this garage door opener charges a monthly subscription in order for you to open and close your garage door. Some people say no, that's not true. Well, it's somewhat true. Chamberlin does charge you a monthly subscription fee to access your garage door using Google. If you're just going to open and close your garage door using the Chamberlin app, then there is no subscription fee. We are going to be looking at how limited this hub really is, compatible with most garage openers manufactured after 1993. So yes, this does support other garage doors besides Chamberlin. All right, so let's go ahead and open the box. We'll do a quick unboxing. All right, so here's the hub. A lot smaller than the linear hub. Here's the quick start guide. Here's the open close sensor. And what else? This last box should be the power adapter. So power adapter and mounting brackets. Alrighty. Okay, as I said before, this is the Chamberlin hub. This is the sensor. Here's the bracket to mount it. And here's a power adapter. So let's go ahead and install this. So my first step was to remove the go control hub. Once I remove that, then I can install the bracket for the MYQ hub. Once the bracket are installed, I can go ahead and snap in the MYQ hub and then plug it in. And then we move to the next step, which is installing the sensor. To install the sensor, I just pre-drilled some holes, then drilled in the sensor, put on the cover, and that was it. Next up was to pair the sensor with the MYQ hub, and after it's paired, the app will tell you to go to your garage door opener and hit the learning button, which is usually yellow on Chamberlin garage door openers. Then use the app and make sure that it works. And as you can see right here, the app works just fine. Give it a moment and the app will update. Bam! Alright, so now to integrate it with Smartthings. Link to this GitHub website is in the description below. Click on the link for the MYQ Garage Door device handler, and you're going to copy this entire code. Once you copy the entire code, go ahead and go to your Smartthings IDE webpage. Click on New Device Handler. Click on Paste from Code. Paste the code and save. And then do Publish for me. Next, we need the code for the Smart App, so click on the link and then copy the entire code for the Smart App. Then go back to your IDE webpage, go to My Smart Apps, do New Smart App, click on From Code and paste the code, hit Create. And once you hit Create, just do Publish and then For Me. Now go to your SmartThings app on your mobile device and then click on Smart App, and you're going to look for MYQ Lite, and then you're going to type in your username and your password. After it logs you in, it's going to ask you which garage door you want to control. Select your garage door, and if you have any contact sensors, you can go ahead and select that. If you don't, you can just hit Next and then hit Save. MYQ Lite is now installed and automating. So then go to Things, and you should see the garage door opener. And here it is. Now you can get a Zwave tilt sensor and pair it with Smartthings, or you can try a open and closed door sensor, which I did, which also works, but mounting it is a little bit more trickier than using a tilt sensor. So if you do want Smartthings to be able to tell if the garage is open or closed, get a Zwave tilt sensor. Because the tilt sensor the MYQ Hub comes with is not Zwave, it doesn't communicate with the Smartthings Hub, it only communicates with the MYQ Hub. Alright, so we got it working with Smartthings, great. So what's next? Well, to share this garage door opener with Alexa and Google, we have to go back into the smart app settings, like when we first set it up, and look for this create on off push buttons. Make sure it's turned on. This needs to be turned on in order for you to be able to use Google and Alexa to open and close the garage door. So go back into the smart app, go into the settings, and make sure this is turned on. Okay, so once you share the garage door with Google, go into the home app, click on new routine, and add a new command, and then type in open garage door. Click save, do add action, and then go ahead and look for the garage door, and we want it to turn on the garage door. So go adjust switches, look for garage door. Here it is. Turn on. And then we can hit save. Okay. Now we're gonna make one for closed garage doors. So add command. When I say close garage door, save, add action, adjust lights, plugs, and more. Look for a garage door, and this time we want it to turn off the garage door. Hit add, save, and that's that. Now with Alexa, it was a little bit more trickier. We couldn't exactly duplicate what we were able to do with the Google Home app, which is create a routine and then set our own command. I mean, technically you're supposed to be able to do this with Alexa, but for some reason I could not get it to work. So for the time being, Alexa works with it. I just have to say, turn on garage door to open or turn off garage door to close. No biggie. Moment of truth, Google, open garage door. Now I do have to mention that at the time of wrapping up this video, MyQ has announced that their subscription to Google is now free for a limited time. So you can go on their website and you can sign up for the Google integration with no credit card needed, and they'll give it to you for a limited time. However, there is a drawback. There's no telling how long this is gonna last, but I have to be honest with you, I don't like it. You have to say, hey Google, talk to MyQ and all that yada yada yada. It is nothing like using this Smartthings hack. This Smartthings hack is so much more easier. And then here's Google closing the garage door. And as you can see, the lights flashing, giving that warning. And the garage door should start closing. So yeah, even though MyQ is offering it for free, I would, you know, I tested it out and it's not as simple as using the Smartthing hack. And that's just for you people who are wondering, well, what's the point of this hack then? And that does it for this video. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. If you thought this video was helpful, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, and if you thought it was awful, thumbs down work also. Thanks for watching. Peace. I'll see you in the next one.